الحمد لله رب العالمين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء إمام البلغاء أمير الفصحاء مولانا رسول الله
صلى الله عليه وسلم
وعلى آله وصحابته وأهل بيته الشرفاء ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أيها الأخوة, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving us opportunity to be here today to glorify His name, to thank Him for the bounties He bestowed upon us. And we declare there is no God worthy to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we declare our beloved Prophet Muhammad
sallallahu
alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah, beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, in Surah Al-Ahzab, He said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اِذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ ذِكْرًا كَسِيرًا وَصَبِّحُوهُ بُقْرَةً وَأَصِيلًا. Indeed, you those who believe in Allah, mention the name of Allah. Remember Allah abundantly in your life. Remember Allah. When you remember Allah, you mention His name. Abundantly. There is no limit of it. It's unlimited. Allah said, remember Allah, zikran kathira, abundantly, wasabbihu, and glorify the name of Allah, bukratan, morning, wa asilan, and the evening. Make sure in a day you glorify the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, zikrullah in Surah Al-Jumu'ah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, He said, فَإِذَا قَدَيْتُمْ صَلَاتَ. When you finish Salat al-Jum'ah, فَانْتَشِرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Go on the surface of earth, spread on the surface of earth. Why? Seek for what you are going to eat. Because as we are sitting down here, there are people who are waiting after Salat, they go to job, they go to work. But when they come back, Allah said, فَانْتَشِرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَابْتَبُوا مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ. Seek from the bounties of Allah. The bounties. Allah has given you some strength. Go and use it and get what you eat. Allah has given you knowledge. Go and use it and get what you eat. But when you come back, fazkurullah zikran kaseera, you have to mention and thank Allah. Remember Allah in everything. Hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, مَثَلُ الَّذِي يَذْكُرُ اللَّهِ وَمَثَلُ الَّذِي لَا يَذْكُرُ اللَّهِ كَمَثَلُ الْحَيِّ وَالْمَيِّتِ. The difference between the one who mentions the name of Allah and the one who does not mention the name of Allah is like living and death. You are Muslim. You are praying 5 daily prayers, but you don't have time to mention the name of Allah. To Allah, you are deaf already. But when you pray and you mention the name of Allah in your time that you have, you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are like living. To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah mentioned also in the Quran, He said, فَذُكُرُونِي أَذْكُرُكُمْ وَشْكُرُونِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ. Allah said, remember me, I will remember you. I shall remember you. Mention my name, I shall mention your name. So remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has become something important to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When you look at the books of Hadith, Imam Bukhari, Imam Muslim, these are the two shaykhan who their hadith ulama classify it as authentic books after Quran. So when you see hadith, they say rawahu shaykhan. When you see hadith, it's narrated by two shaykh, that is Bukhari and Muslim. Bukhari and Muslim, all their books, they have bring a part, babu zikrullah, kitabu zikrullah. When you look at Imam al-Nawawi in his book Riyad al-Salihin, he bring kitabu babu zikrullah, special chapter for zikrullah. Because zikrullah, remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is nothing like remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sometimes you look at it, the way Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam put the station or the degree of remembrance of Allah, you think as if you have to even stop salat and then do the zikr because of the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. An Abi Dardai radiallahu anhu kala kala Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ala unabdiukum bi khayri a'malikum The Sahaba were sitting with Prophet Muhammad. With Prophet Muhammad. Prophet told them, do you want me to show you the best work that you can do to Allah? Brothers and sisters, we should listen to the statement of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Do you want me to show you the best work you can do to Allah, then Allah will love it? وَأَزْكَاهَا إِنْدَ مَلِكِكُمْ. And very pure work to your Lord, to your Creator. The work that you do, your Creator will appreciate. Do you want me to teach you? وَأَرْفَعَهَا فِي دَرَجَاتِكُمْ. And it shall give you high position the day of judgment day. Not only the day of judgment day. While you are in dunya, people look at you as nothing, but to Allah, you are the best. Do you want me to show you what you can do? Then Allah will love you. Allah will give you high status. وَخَيْرٌ لَكُمْ مِنْ إِنْفَاقِ الذَّهَبِ. Subhanallah. And the work that I'm going to teach you is better for you to even give sadaqah of your gold that you have in your house. Subhanallah. Nowadays we think when somebody give money, it's a great person. But now Rasul is telling us that you're giving gold or diamond to poor people or to people, wallahi, does not get closer to somebody who Prophet Muhammad is what he's going to tell us. He said, I'm going to show you what is better, more than giving sadaqah of infaq al-dhahab wal-fadda. And Prophet said, wa khayrun lakum. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. Prophet said, wa khayrun lakum min an talqu adwaqum. Fatadribu ahnaqihim wa yadribu ahnaqikum. Subhanallah. The reason why Prophet Muhammad is mentioning all this, because all these have position in the Quran. مثل الذين ينفقون أموالهم في سبيل الله كمثل حبة أنبتت سبع سنابل في كل سنبلة مئة حبة والله يضاعف لمن يشاء والله واسع عليم. That is infaq al-zahab wal-fadda. Allah has given a high position to those who give in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, let me show you something which you as a Muslim, you believe in Prophet Muhammad, you go to jihad and fight the adu Allah, a'da Allah, the kuffar, the name enemies of Islam. Prophet is telling them why Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam have given them the high position of those who will be killed in the battlefield. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَا تَحْسَبَنَّ الَّذِينَ قُتِلُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أَمْوَاتًا بَلْ هُمْ أَحْيَاءٌ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ يُرْزَقُونَ. These are the position of those who went to battlefield and they were killed. Allah said, do not think they are dead. They are still alive with their Lord. He's giving them provision. Now Prophet Muhammad is telling us there is something more than that. Allahu Akbar. No. In this hadith, Prophet Muhammad is telling us there is something you can do for you to achieve position more than this, what Allah said in the Quran. Prophet said, فَتُلْقُوا أَتُوَّكُمْ. You meet your enemy. فَتَدْرِبُوا أَحْنَاقِهِمْ. You shall strike on their necks. And they shall strike on your neck and you get you dead. You become dead. But there is something more than this. وَهِيَ ذِكْرُ اللَّهِ. For you to mention the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's better than you to go to war. It's better. Zikrullah. The reason why zikrullah, mentioning the name of Allah, is very, very important. When you mention the name of Allah, يَنْقَطِعُ خَطَرَاتِ الشَّيْطَانِ. خَطَر. فِكْر. شَيْطَانِيَّ فِي أَقْلِ الْمَعْ. Thinking of evil will stop when you mention the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because when you mention the name of Allah, Allah get closer to you at every time. If Allah is closer to you, would you involve yourself in the action that Allah doesn't want? No. That's why mentioning the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is very, very important. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ana inda zanni abdi bi. I am where my servant think I am. That is where I am. فَإِنْ ذَكَرَنِي فِي نَفْسِهِ If my servant sit down, subhanallah, subhanallah, in his heart, I will mention my servant's name. وَإِنْ ذَكَرَنِي فِي مَلَئٍ When he come to mosque, where people sit down, he sit down, they do zikr together. Allah said, I shall mention all of them, each one of them, their names. خَيْرُ مَلَئِ The best jama'ah, which are angels. مَلَئِ الْأَعْلَى If your name is being mentioned among the angels, subhanallah, the angels regard you. So when you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to mention your name, then you don't have to play with the zikrullah. Mentioning remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, brothers and sisters, one time the poor people of Mecca, those who migrate from Mecca to Medina, it's obvious the Ansar, Medina people, because they are in their place. So they have so many alternatives to make money. But those who came from Mecca, they don't have any alternatives because they are strangers. Even though they are long time, 1 year, 2 years in Medina, but there are certain corners, they don't know how to get some money. So they came to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, Ya Rasulullah, the rich people are going higher and leave us. The rich people are getting, they are going higher. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Fama zaka, what do you mean? Rasulullah didn't understand what he said, Fama zaka, mahala. And they said, Ya Rasulullah, we are talking about the rich people among our means here. They pray, we pray. We fast, they fast. Everything that we do, they do. But because of their money, they are able to give a lot of money for going to war. Because when there is a war, Prophet Muhammad will say, everyone should bring his sadaqah so that we buy the weapons. And anybody who buy weapons, his daraja will climb. They have money to give sadaqah. They can go to Hajj. But we are poor people. So what do you say about that? Prophet Muhammad he look at them and tell them, Ala u'allimukum shay'an tudrikuna bihi man sabakakum? Do you want me to show you something that when you do it, you shall catch the one who is ahead of you? Tudrikuna bihi man sabakakum? Those who are ahead of you is like race. Yeah? Somebody who is ahead of you, you do something to get him. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, do you want me to show you that? Tudrikuna bihi man sabakakum? وَتُسْبِقُونَ بِهِ مَنْ بَعْدَكُمْ And you shall go ahead and leave those who are coming behind you. Do you want me to show you? When I see this hadith in Kitab Riyad al-Salihin, I said, look at wonderful thing Prophet Muhammad is telling us. But that is what all of us here are playing with. This is what Prophet said. He said, when you do it, you shall meet the one who is ahead of you. And the one who is behind you will never catch you. Except the person do illa man sana'a misla ma sana'tum. Except the person do what you do before you can be the same with the person. Do you want me to show you this? The Sahaba, the poor Sahaba, they say, Kalu bala ya Rasulullah. Ya Rasulullah, teach us. Kala fasabbihun wa tuhammidun wa tukabbirun khalfa kulli salat 33 marra. This is what we know. Prophet said, after every salat, do when Imam say Assalamu alaikum, don't stand. Sit down and say Subhanallah, Subhanallah 33 times. Walhamdulillah, Walhamdulillah 33 times. Wallahu Akbar 33 times. Wallahi, you can be the same like the one who is giving more money. But if the rich man is also doing it, he will be ahead of you again. Because Prophet Muhammad, he said, Illa man sana'a misla ma sana'tum. Except the one who do what you do. So if the rich man also gives sadaqah, and you do subhanallah, walhamdulillah, he shall always be ahead of you. But you, those who don't have anything to give sadaqah, this is what you can do to catch, to meet the rich man who don't have time to do zikr. So brothers and sisters, from today, sometime when we come and we listen to something, we have to take it and put it into practice. From today, after every salat, do not neglect. This is a command of Prophet Muhammad.
Sallallahu
alayhi wa sallam. And some people don't read it very well. They do... Subhanallah. When you do zikr, you have to take your time. Subhanallah, 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 subhanallah. 33 times. Walhamdulillah, walhamdulillah. Wallahu akbar. Allah loved it so much because you are glorifying the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وفي حديث الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول الحمد لله تملأ الميزان لا إله إلا الله الحمد لله تملأ الميزان. For you to say الحمد لله, it full up your scale the day of judgment day. One الحمد لله, سبحان الله تملأ الميزان, والحمد لله تملأان وتملأ ما بين السماوات والأرض لا إله إلا الله. When you say Subhanallah, Walhamdulillah, Walhamdulillah will fill between heaven and earth that your reward. These are little things we don't consider, but it will give us high stature before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah accept our prayer. May Allah forgive us our sins. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive our parents, our fathers who pass away. May Allah forgive them their sins. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase our iman. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us in this country. Our children, may Allah protect them. May Allah protect their iman. May Allah exalt the name of Islam. May Allah exalt the name of Islam. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأظل الشرك والمشركين وارضى عن الخلفاء الراشدين أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن بقية الصحابة أجمعين. اللهم لا تدع عن ذنبا إلا غفرته, ولا حما إلا فرجته, ولا دينا إلا قضيته, ولا مريدا إلا شفيته, ولا عضوا إلا قهرته, ولا حاجة من حوائج الدنيا والآخرة إلا قضيتها برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين يا رب العالمين. عباد الله قوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله.